بسم الله، الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, again this is our third trial to try to see if we can produce a home video. Like I said, this is nothing but a trial. It's a one-man show. The same man is talking, is the same man that charge of the light and the camera, name it. Nevertheless, we try to produce information more than cosmetics or appearance and things like that. Let's see how this trial will work, and maybe we can go from there, inshallah, after your comments. We're still reading from the book 40 حديثا قدسيا by الشيخ حائد القرني جزاه الله خيرا. الحديث السابع عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: قال الله تعالى: أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. فاقرأوا إن شئتم فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين. سورة السجدة verse number 17 رواه البخاري. This is the seventh hadith from a hadith Qudsi reported by Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, Allah the Almighty is saying, I had prepared for my righteous slaves what no eye had seen, no ear had heard, no human being can imagine. Read the statement of Allah if you want. No soul can conceive what been hidden for them from the coolness of their eyes. This hadith in the collection of Imam al-Bukhari. This hadith that Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is informing us about the reward and what he had prepared for the righteous slaves of him. Not any ibad, but as-salihin, the righteous one. So that means the ibad of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are degree. Some of them a slave, some of them a good slave, some of them is an excellent slave, some of them more devoted than the others. Nevertheless, Allah is saying that a'adat to. So Allah had prepared. So this means tells us that Jannah is already been created and the pleasure and the reward is already been prepared. So Jannah is already been created and this is part of our belief. What Allah had prepared for the righteous slaves of him, ما لا عين رأت. He had prepared something that no eye ever had seen before like it. From the pleasure, neither any ear had heard about from that pleasure that he prepared. Whatever you heard, you never heard something like what Allah had prepared. And any heart or any mind can conceive anything of imagination. What Allah had prepared is beyond even your ability to imagine. And he said, فَقْرَأُوا إِنْ شِئْتُمْ read if you wish, as a support to this statement, the verse from Surah Sajda, prostration, verse number 17, which Almighty Allah is saying, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ. No soul can conceive or can imagine or can get to know What been storage or been hidden for them from things which will have the coolness of their eyes? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with this great pleasure. Ameen. Next hadith, hadith number 8. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال يتنزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى كل ليلة إلى سماء الدنيا حين يبقى ثلث الليل الآخر فيقول من يدعوني فأستجيب له من يسألني فأعطيه من يستغفرني فأغفر له رواه البخاري Hadith number 8. The 8th hadith reported by Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, Our Lord Almighty descend every night to the lowest heaven when one third of the night still remaining, and he will say, Who's supplicating me? I will answer him. Who's asking me, begging me for something? I will give him. Who seeks my forgiveness? I'll forgive for him. This hadith shows us the virtues of the last part of the night, which is the last third of the night, and also inform us about one of Allah's action, which is an-nuzul, descend. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he do whatever he wants, whenever he wants, in a manner that fits with his majesty. We don't know how, but we believe in it. What does Allah do? He comes down to the lowest heaven. How? We don't know how, but we are obligated to believe in it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will say, so this also telling us about Allah, that Allah speak, that Allah will say something. What he will say? Who is calling in me? Where those who are calling on me? So I can answer their call. Where those who begging me for something, so I will give them. Where those who seek my forgiveness, so I can forgive them. So this is our opportunity, that we be in Qiyam al-Layl, prayer at night, or even not in prayer, but at least will be in supplication, we will get this great reward that Allah had informed about it. Next hadith, al-hadith al-tasi', the ninth hadith, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا أحب الله العبد نادى جبريل إن الله يحب فلانا فأحبه فيحبه جبريل فينادي جبريل في أهل السماء إن الله يحب فلانا فأحبه فيحبه أهل السماء ثم يوضع له القبول في الأرض رواه البخاري ninth hadith which reported by Abu Huraira. May Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, when Almighty Allah loves a slave of him, he will call Jibreel. Indeed, Allah loves so and so, so love him. As a result of this, Jibreel will love him. Jibreel will call on the dwellers of the heaven or the skies, saying, indeed Allah loves so and so, so love him. So so the dwellers of the heaven, they will love him. As a result of this, acceptance will be put in the earth for such a person. This hadith tells us about that Allah loves, and we affirm this to Allah, and this means that there is certain acts which Allah loved, and in return Allah will love those who acting upon it. And how Allah loves, we don't know, but we believe that Allah loves. And when Allah loves someone, and of course Allah will love him for what he is, the good deeds that he's doing, the belief, he will say to Jibreel, that Allah is saying to Jibreel that he loves so and so. As a result of this, Allah will order Jibreel to love this person. As a result of this, Jibreel will love this person whom Allah love him. Then Jibreel will call on the dwellers of the skies, the angels, and he will inform them that Allah Almighty, he loves so and so. So Jibreel also will order them to love this person. As a result of this, they will love him, the angels will love him. Now the acceptance will be put in the earth for such a person. That means the people will accept him, the people will love him, the people will like to draw closer to him, the people will welcome him, the people will have their hearts open for such a person. May Allah make us among those people by His mercy. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين, and Allah knows best.